number, y'all.
Yes.
Well, they might have went to Lowe's or Home Depot. The difference was not in the plans. The difference was not in the materials. But the difference was in the foundation. I come by to let you know that Jesus is our foundation.
Jesus,
he's coming back for his church. He's coming back for his church that is built on a solid foundation. It doesn't matter how many times you have gone to church. It doesn't matter how many times you led presses. It doesn't matter how many times you have led the songs in the choir, but you have not been washed in the blood of Jesus. Your faith is just like sinking sand. If your faith does not have a little bit of Jesus, I say you gotta have just a little bit of Jesus. Every now and then you gotta have a talk with Jesus, and he'll make it all right. You got Jesus. Come back and tell you, your life is built on the right foundation. I don't worry about my soul, because my soul is anchored in the Lord. The church needs a foundation mixed with a little love. A foundation mixed with a little grace. A foundation mixed with a little mercy. A foundation mixed with a little faith. A foundation mixed with a little hope, because my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus, blood and righteousness. Jesus, he's my rock. Jesus, he's the one. When storms may rise and the winds may blow, my soul is anchored in the Lord. Is there anybody here? Is there anybody here been anchored in Jesus? Because when you're anchored in Jesus, you will not waver from side to side. When the winds blow, you will stand right there. When the storms come, you will stand right there. My house, my tabernacle, my soul will never waver. I'm glad a palm tree. No matter how the winds blow, no matter how the storm comes, I may lean to the right side, and I may lean to the left side, I may lean backwards, and I may lean forward, but when the storm is over, I'm anchored, and I'll stand straight up, and I'll shine. I'm glad that I got Jesus. Somebody need to hold to his unchanging hand. Hold on to his hand. Hold on to his hand. Because his hand will pick you up out of the muck and the miry clay. His hand will turn you around. His hand will lead you. You'll never forsake him, because the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He leads me, he guides me, he walks with me. Have you tried it today? Has the Lord been good to you? You ought to wave your head and say, yeah, I'm anchored in Jesus. My rock is solid. I can thank God for a solid rock. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Make sure you're on a solid foundation. Jesus has already formed the church upon that foundation. But you, as the body of Christ, got to make sure you're anchored in Jesus. Make sure your foundation is solid. Make sure your foundation will stand the storm.
Yes.
Cause sure, you're gonna have a storm.
Amen.
Oh, you're gonna have a storm, brothers and sisters. No matter when you least expect, a storm will come. A storm will come like a thief in the night. But when it comes, when you're anchored in Jesus and your foundation is solid, truly, you can survive the storm.
Amen.
The church was built on that rock over 2,000 years ago. And even today, it's still standing. Even today, the church still has its place in the salvation of our soul. There are members that have come and they have gone. There are souls that have died and gone on to be with the Lord. But in that great getting up morning, I said in that great getting up morning, when the trumpet sounds and the dead in Christ shall rise, we'll be caught up to meet him in the air. But your foundation got to be solid. Your foundation has to be anchored in Jesus. And when it is, that mansion that's waiting for you got your name on it. Do you want to be there? Do you want to see it? Do you want to see your love? Do you want to see Abraham? Do you want to see Isaac? Do you want to see Jacob? Do you want to see Joseph? But mostly, do you want to see Jesus? You got to have that anchor. And you got to have a solid foundation. This is what the church is all about. Jesus was teaching to his disciples and to the multitudes. And we're the multitude. The multitude is still being talked to through his word. And when we read God's word, we should put a little effort in trying to keep it. We may not be perfect, because we're all sinners. Huh? Let me say this. I know we don't have a lot of young people here, but the church needs to save our young people.
Yes.
The young man that shot the girl, not intentionally, but he shot the gun.
Yes.
Hit the girl and she's still in a coma.
Yes.
He thought he was going to get away.
Yes.
But they found him.
Amen.
Our young people need. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not obey my commandments? Our young people need to get back to Christ. Because things that they're doing today, I know we got old, but we did some crazy things, but we didn't do nothing like that. Huh? What young people are doing, and they're getting life in prison. Huh? Life. You see in Ocala, the girl and the boy and all those?
Yes.
16 years old.
Yes.
Some of y'all got kids 16 years old. Life in prison. And in Florida, life means life.
Yes.
It's all about the foundation. But we must not obey it. It leads to Satan getting in our life.
Amen.
And Jesus says, he ain't coming into church. This church is protected. That gates of hell will not prevail. But when you go out into the world, Satan is waiting on you. Come out of the church and go into the world. He's waiting on you.
Oh, yes.
Because now you lost your protection.
All right.
I'm just talking. But I just want people to know that if you got that foundation and you hold on to your covenant with the Lord,
yes,
and you stay in the church,
yes,
don't lose faith, don't lose hope, and maintain your grace with the Lord, you will endure to the end.
Yes.
I hope I have said something that may have helped somebody
yes
here tonight.
Yes.
There may be someone here tonight who don't know Jesus and the pardon of their sins. We want to offer Christ to you tonight. We know that people may be, some of you have been in the church a long time, but sometimes somebody may want to come in from the outside. I just want to open the doors of the church that they say, I want to extend an invitation to discipleship, where if one want to come and give their life to Christ, they may do so.